Hello, my dear friends. Good morning to all of you. I welcome you here again in this discussion. Today's discussion, it is on the topic number of atoms in a unit cell. It is from the chapter solid state. We know that about the crystal lattice, it is made up of a very large number of unit cells, and every lattice point is occupied by one constituent particle, which may be atom, molecule or ion. And also we have read about the unit cell and the types of unit cell, like the primitive and the centered unit cell. Today we will discuss about the number of atoms in a primitive cubic unit cell, number of atoms in a body centered cubic unit cell, and number of atoms in a face centered cubic unit cell. First one, it is in the case of a primitive cubic unit cell. In case of primitive cubic unit cell, first we have to again discuss about the primitive cubic unit cell. Means in this case, primitive means here the atoms, here it is present only at the corners only, and the edge length, that is the ABC, are equal, and the axial angle, that is the alpha, beta and gamma, it is also equal and is equal to 90 degree. So here, to find out the number of atoms in primitive cubic unit cell, you observe this figure given just below here. You will see that in this case, suppose this is one layer, this one, it is the one layer, and it has four unit cells, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the second layer just above the first one, it also has four unit cells, 1, 2, 3, 4. In this case, the number of unit cell within that whole one, it is total 8, and here the contribution of one atom, it is actually 1/8 to a particular unit cell. For this one, consider this atom. Suppose here this is the atom, it belongs to the 4 unit cell in this layer, and also with this 4 unit cell in the upper layer. So here, if we calculate the number of atoms, then in this unit cell, consider this one, in this unit cell, the contribution of this atom, it is 1/8. Similarly, in this unit cell, the contribution or portion of this atom, it is present here, it is 1/8. Similarly, in this one, 1/8, 1/8 already present. In the second layer, suppose this is the first and this is the second layer, just above it, the same way, 1/8, 1/8 part, it is already present in each unit cell. So here, total number of atoms in a primitive cubic unit cell, come here, this one, it is the primitive cubic unit cell. Consider this case, suppose this is the one unit, second unit may be here, third one may be suppose just above it, next suppose in this side another unit, a number of units will be present there. Then consider any atom, suppose this one unit cell, contribution of this atom to this particular unit cell, it is 1/8. Similarly, 1/8 part of the atom, it is also present here. Number of atoms total here, it is to be calculated by considering the contribution or the portion present in that unit cell. Total number of atoms in the primitive cubic unit cell, it will be 8 into 1 by 8. 8 for 8 corners and 1 by 8, that is the contribution of one atom to that unit cell, it is 1/8. Therefore, it comes 1 into 1, it will be 1 atom. So here, in the primitive cubic unit cell, the total number of atoms, it will be only 1. Now come to the second. In a body-centered cubic unit cell, in the body-centered cubic unit cell, atoms are already present at the corners, total 8 corners. All the corners are occupied by an atom, and one atom, it is present at its body center. Suppose this is the unit cell, and this position, it represents its body center. One atom, it is present in its body center, and it can be seen that the atom at the body center wholly belongs to the unit cell in which it is present. So here, this atom, it is wholly present within this unit cell. Therefore, total number of atoms in a body-centered cubic unit cell, it will be 8 into 1 by 8, 8 for 8 corners, and 1/8 part or 1/8 portion, it is means present in that unit cell, plus 1 into 1, one atom at its body center, and then it comes 1 plus 1, that is 2 atoms. Therefore, in a body-centered cubic unit cell, the total number of atoms, it will be 2. In the third, that is, in a face-centered cubic unit cell, the atoms are already present at the corners. 8 corners are occupied by the atoms, means here, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 corners are there and atoms are present. In addition to these atoms which are present at the corners, one atom is also present on the center of the each face. Consider this atom. Suppose this is the face. In this case, suppose here it is the center of the face, then one atom, it is present at the center of the face. Similarly, suppose for this face, here it represents the center of this face. So here, one atom, it is present at the center of this face. Similarly, here, suppose for this face, it is the center. One atom is also present for this one, one atom. And for the two other faces, suppose this is one face, this side, and this represents the center where the atom is present. And for that face, just behind this one, suppose this atom, it represents the center of this face. So here total 6 faces are there, and therefore 6 atoms will be present, and these atoms will be present at the centers of each face. Consider this case. Suppose this is one unit cell, this one, it represents one unit cell. This is the suppose one unit cell. Another unit cell is just here, shared with this unit cell. Suppose this one, it is the another unit cell. Now one atom, it is present here. This represents the atom. Now contribution of this atom in these two unit cell, you will see that 50% of the atom will be present in this unit cell, suppose this one, and 50% of the atom, that is half, here it will be present in the other unit cell which is shared with this one. Similarly, Suppose another unit cell is here just above, below, any side. So here, atom which is present in the center of the face, it contributes to the particular atom. It is only 50%, that is, if it's half to the unit cell. Therefore, total number of atoms in a face-centered cubic unit cell, it will be 8 into 1 by 8. 8 means for 8 corners, and 1 by 8, that is the contribution of one atom towards this unit cell, it is 1/8 plus 6 faces. For here, suppose 6 faces, 6 into 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means contribution of one atom, that is here, suppose total 6 faces, 1 by 2, 50% means half of the atom it is present in that unit cell, then it comes to be 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. So here, the total number of atoms in a face-centered cubic unit cell, it is 4 atoms. So we have observed here that the total number of atoms in a primitive cubic unit cell, it is only 1. The total number of atoms in a body-centered cubic unit cell, it is 2. And the total number of atoms in a face-centered cubic unit cell, it is 4. I think today's discussion here, it's clear to you. The next discussion, it will be on the topic close packed structures, and there will be the discussion about the close packing in one dimension, two dimensions, and three dimensions. Okay, thank you, take care, and have a good day.